Hello, and welcome to this video presentation. My name is Ada MacDonald, and I'm Dean for the Bilingual Matura in French and English at Renon High School in Switzerland. Originally from Great Britain, I'm going to give this presentation in my native language. However, for those of you who aren't so confident in English, I can reassure you that each slide is also available in French. All of the information in this presentation is also available online at vd.ch/gymnase. Please don't hesitate to contact me if you have any particular questions at aidan.macdonald@vd.ch. If many of you ask the same question, then I will establish a frequently asked questions document to share with everybody. Here you can see an outline of today's presentation. And without further ado, we'll move on to the impact of coronavirus on your year abroad. On the 20th of March, the British government closed all schools in the UK until further notice in order to prevent the spread of the virus. And the schools at the moment foresee a reopening for August 2020, with the caveat that the evolution of the virus has improved sufficiently to allow everybody to return to school. In the meantime, the process of preparation, inscription, etc. must continue, and we must be prepared for all eventualities. It is our hypothesis that your year abroad will take place, and therefore we must prepare for that. Now I'd like to talk a little bit more generally about new developments this year. Following the changes to the programme whereby we no longer send students to school in Australia, Canada, or the USA, we've focused on England and Wales for the past year. This year we've been very active and we've been able to make a number of new partnerships to allow as many students as we can to take part in the programme. Consequently, you'll notice that this year we did not have to have a lottery in order to decide who can participate in the programme, and all 89 students were able to be offered a school in accordance with the places available. Just a reminder that the reason why you've been selected for a particular school is in relation to the options available. Specifically, not all schools offer psychology and philosophy, and not all schools are able to offer Spanish. In addition, we try to match the schools with the students so that each student is with a buddy from their original high school. But this buddy is usually not doing the same OS as you. Nevertheless, there is always somebody else in the same class. So you should all be with somebody else from Switzerland, and there should be a familiar face from your original high school with you in the school. Now I'd like to present the different partner schools, where they are in England and where they are in relation to each other. So to kick off, at the beginning of the alphabet, we have Ulster Grammar School, a selective secondary school for students aged between 12 and 18, which is located near Birmingham in the centre of England. We've been working with Ulster now for just over a year. Next, we have Bexhill College, located on the south coast. Bexhill is a further education college for students over 16, and this will be the first year that we work with Bexhill. Next, we have Chrisleton High School, a selective secondary school for students aged between 12 and 18, which is located just outside of Chester. We've been working with Chrisleton now for just over a year. The College of Richard Collier, another school with whom we've been working for just over a year, is located in Sussex. It's a further education college for students aged 16 and over. Denmark Road High School is a new partnership. It's a selective secondary school for students aged between 12 and 18. The middle school is a single-sex girls' school, and the high school, the gymnase, is mixed. Denmark Road is, I think, one of the smallest partner schools with whom we are working this year. Exeter College is another new partnership. It's located in the extreme south west of England. It's a further education college for students aged 16 and over. Harrogate Grammar School, a selective secondary school for students aged between 12 and 18, is located in the north of England. It's about 20 minutes away from Leeds, and we've been working with Harrogate now for just over a year. Holcombe Grammar School is one of the oldest partnerships that we have. We started working with Holcombe back in 2015. It is a selective secondary school for students aged between 12 and 18. And the middle school is a single-sex school for boys, but the high school, the gymnase, is mixed. Portsmouth College is located on the south coast. It's a further education college for students aged 16 and over, and this will be the first year that we are sending students to Portsmouth. Radder Comprehensive School is a mixed, non-selective secondary school for students aged between 12 and 18 in Cardiff. And the Rochester Grammar School is located just next to Holcombe Grammar School. It's also a selective secondary school for students aged between 12 and 18. And as the middle school at Holcombe is for boys, the middle school for Rochester is for girls, although the high school, the gymnase, is also mixed. Sheldon School is a non-selective secondary school for students aged between 12 and 18. This will be the third year that we work with Sheldon. St Mary Magdalene's Academy in London is one of the first schools with whom we had a partnership in England. It's a secondary school for students aged between 12 and 18. Stroud High School is a selective secondary school for students aged between 12 and 18. The middle school is for girls, although the high school is mixed. We've been working with Stroud now for just over a year. Whitchurch High School is a new partnership for us, although it has strong connections with Radder, and like Radder, it is also a non-selective secondary school for students aged between 12 and 18. It is the biggest high school in Wales. Finally, York College is a further education college located in Yorkshire. It's for students aged 16 and over, and we've been working with York now for 4 years. Before I go on to talk about pedagogical follow-up over the year abroad, I'd just like to give you a little bit of information about the different British schools and their equivalents in Switzerland. So you'll have noticed that many schools are selective. They are called grammar schools or high schools. And these schools require students to pass a test when they're 12 in order to enter the school. In this way, the schools are more similar to La Voie Pré-Gymnasiale and the École de Maturité. Other schools in the UK are non-selective, such as Sheldon or Radder. And these schools are more similar to our Swiss schools in that they offer a variety of different pathways to students. Finally, you'll have noticed that there are some colleges. These are for students over 16 years old, and they offer both vocational and academic qualifications. In this way, they are more similar to our professional schools with a maturer track. So, our students, when they're in the UK, will follow the same program as the local students. Having explained the differences with the British schools, you'll have noticed that the Swiss curriculum is not exactly the same as the British curriculum. And this, for me, is the interesting part of the programme. It's what makes it exciting. Students will be expected to adapt and learn new skills according to these circumstances. The work, therefore, is significant before leaving, during the trip, and of course, when the students come back to Switzerland, because they're going to have to readapt to the Swiss educational system. The A-level is an abbreviation of advanced level, and it's an exam taken by all British students following 2 years of study at the end of their high school. It's equivalent to the second and third year of our École de Maturité. In this way, the A-level is necessary to enter university. The number of A-levels taken by each student is variable, but the usual method is to take 4 subjects, equivalent to 300 minutes per subject per week, bearing in mind that for each hour of teaching, you're going to have 1 hour of homework. If you are German speaking and you take German as a second language, can you please get in touch with us so that we can confirm which subjects you should take during your time abroad? It would obviously be useless for you to take German as a second language, and you could take another subject, such as geography, in its stead. In order to do your homework, some schools loan students iPads or laptop computers, and others make fixed desktop computers available in their libraries, which remain open until around 7 o'clock in the evening. Nevertheless, we do advise you to take your own laptop computers so that you can do your homework more easily. I repeat, it's not an obligation, but it is nevertheless a good idea to take these with you. In order to ensure good communication, please, please, please check your EduConnect mailboxes regularly. It's our main method of communication with you. And some students who don't do this have a number of difficulties. I can think of one in particular concerning the choice of option complémentaire for your third year at Renault, because I will send you a unique token via your EduConnect email around November, December time. And if you don't use your EduConnect mail and you don't access this unique token, you won't be able to sign up for the OC of your choice. Similarly, as I'm sure you'll appreciate, this year it was very important to have good communication with the students via email so that we could contact them in order to organise their repatriation to Switzerland following the outbreak of the coronavirus. For students who don't check their mail regularly, this can become a huge problem. So again, please, please, please check your EduConnect mail addresses regularly. Now I'd like to talk a little bit about the subjects that you'll be taking during your year abroad. So for most of you, in fact, all of you except for those students who will be going to Rochester Grammar School, you'll be taking 4 A-levels. You'll be taking Maths, German or Italian, English and your OS. If your OS comprises of 2 subjects, such as biology and chemistry, or philosophy and psychology, then you'll be doing these instead of English. For those students who are taking English, we ask you to write a TM linked with English culture, but this can be literally anything, as long as there's a link to English culture. This year, students have done projects linked to AIDS, in Wales, linked to homelessness in Cardiff, linked to a comparison of different international educational systems, linking in particular Switzerland and the UK. If, however, you're doing biology and chemistry or philosophy and psychology and you're not doing English, then we ask you to do a TM based on English literature. In this way, you're going to have some contact with English literature. And again, I just like to stress that this can be quite open. This year, students have done projects as varied as an escape game based on the works of Sherlock Holmes. Others have done the more traditional literary analysis. Others still have directed their own plays, and others have started book clubs. All of these, for me, form what can be called English literature. So really, it's nevertheless quite open. So please don't worry about being restricted by the title. For those students who are going to Rochester Grammar School, you will be doing the International Baccalaureate. So you'll be taking six subjects rather than four, in addition to a TM. The TM is prepared, written, and presented in English in your host school during the second year, or the year abroad. The grade that you get is final. Steps to take in order to succeed, in addition to the calendar for the TM, will be explained and communicated by us, coronavirus permitting, on the 8th of June 2020 from 6 till 8. If, however, it is not possible to have a physical meeting, I will again prepare a video like this one to help you in this process. If you have special educational needs and you have dyslexia, dyspraxia, dyscalculia, or another similar issue, you probably have a medical certificate which you gave to your high school at the beginning of first year, and as a consequence you benefit from extra time for tests, or perhaps your spelling is not taken into consideration. You will benefit from these special measures when you're in the UK. However, your physical student dossier is still in your original high school, and we don't have a list of students with special educational needs. Therefore, we ask you to communicate with us your special educational needs as soon as possible so that we can ensure that you have the correct level of support over your year abroad. To validate your year abroad, you are subject to the same conditions as the other students in your host school. You agree to follow subjects until the end of the school year in the host school. So this means from the beginning of September until the end of July. Meanwhile, the school report and the school rules of your host school are the ones which must be taken into consideration, rather than, for example, the rules of your original high school concerning your graduation from one year to the next. If your year is not validated by your host high school during the year abroad, you will retake your second year of high school in your original Swiss high school. If you don't respect the rules and regulations not only of your host family, school, or even the laws of the country, or indeed the rules of Switzerland, you could face sanctions which can go as far as the return to Switzerland for the student concerned. This is an important aspect because we have had to repatriate students because of this particular rule. The student broke a national law and the host family no longer felt comfortable looking after the student, which meant that it was very difficult to find another place for that student, and they, as a consequence, had to return to Switzerland. So once again, this is an extremely important point to bear in mind. If, for personal reasons, the student decides to return to Switzerland before the end of the year abroad, they will retake their second year of high school from August 2021 in their high school of origin. Of course, we will always take into consideration medical certificates or other similar justifications when deciding on the future of a particular student in any given situation. Once the student returns to Switzerland, in normal circumstances, they'll come back to continue their high school studies at Renon High School, where they have special classes comprised only of students within the bilingual program, and also some extra classes which have been put on especially for them. For example, in geography, which is not taught during the year abroad. The teachers and the deanship are used to dealing with students of the bilingual matura, and we've developed a particular competency in this regard. History in particular is taught in English to meet the criteria of the federal ordinance for the bilingual program. And as I mentioned before, geography is given in the third year. Exams can take into account the two final years of study, and as a consequence, students in the bilingual program are obliged to catch up with any material missed during their year abroad. Nevertheless, thanks to the links between the curriculum in the UK and in Switzerland, exams in maths, in addition to those in the OS, can take into consideration material taught during the year abroad in the UK. The level required of students in the bilingual program is exactly the same as those in all the other classes for the Swiss Matura. A special word on visas. This only concerns four of you. Nevertheless, if you are from a country outside of Switzerland or the European Union, so in this case, Cameroon, Tunisia, or Vietnam, you need to ask for a Tier 4 general student visa in order to enter the UK. The request for a visa is accompanied with a certificate of language proficiency. This is the IELTS UK Visa Academic B2 level and is available from the British Council in Switzerland at a charge of 252 francs. The delay for the processing of visas by the British government is around 3 weeks, and therefore you should start the process in mid-May. The visa costs 348 British pounds. For more information, you should contact the representative of your host school, who can provide more detail about this. Unlike previous years, from now on, flights to and from England are to be organised by the student and their families and are entirely at your charge. Please note that children under 16 must be accompanied by an adult, that is someone who is 16 or over. Children who are not accompanied are not authorised on board EasyJet flights. So, we advise that everybody do the check-in together in order to avoid these problems. For EasyJet, as long as a student who is under 16 is accompanied by someone else over 16, this is not a problem. The charter for the bilingual maturer, which you should now have signed and returned, specifies that the date and place of the meeting are fixed by our partner who is responsible for the homestay and will be announced before the summer holidays. Families are required to respect these dates scrupulously. So, in order to facilitate the organisation of your trip, we advise you to make the reservations according to the table which you will find in the next slide. So, for students going to Cristleton, our recommended flight is with EasyJet on Saturday the 29th of August at 10:35 in the morning, heading to Manchester. The following day, for students going to Denmark Road, Exeter, Radder, Sheldon, Stroud and Whitchurch, our recommended flight is again with EasyJet at 10:50, heading to Bristol. On Monday the 31st of August at 10:55, our recommended flight is to Gatwick for those students going to Portsmouth and St Mary Magdalene's. And later in the day at 4:55, heading to Birmingham for those students going to Ulster. On Tuesday the 1st of September, we have a flight at 2:45 to Manchester for our students heading to York. And then the following weekend, for those students going to Bexhill, Colliers, Holcombe and Rochester, we have a recommended flight on Saturday the 5th of September at 2:45 in the afternoon to Gatwick. Last but not least, for students going to Harrogate, our recommended flight is again with EasyJet on Sunday the 6th of September at 10:35 heading to Manchester. We recommend that you book these flights as far as in advance as possible in order to avoid price fluctuations. And while of course you are free to book or not these recommended flights, we would remind you that the time and place of the meeting with Rick Carby from Barnes Educational Services has been organised in relation to these flights. So Rick will be there to meet you at the arrivals lounge based on these particular flights. In terms of health insurance and other types of insurance, medical consultations with the National Health Service are free for everybody, and your host families will help you to set up your first meeting with a doctor. Barnes Educational Services organises an obligatory travel insurance through Ensley Insurance, which is a branch of Zurich. In addition, we would also recommend that you organise insurance with REGA, just in case of a medical problem which requires repatriation to Switzerland. In order to ensure a good relationship with the students, the families, the host families, we would like you to be aware of the area of the form on the Barnes Educational Services inscription with any extra information that you think is necessary for your stay abroad. In particular, we would like you to indicate your medical needs or your dietary needs, which could affect your placement with a given host family. Just to give you an example, last year, for example, we had one student who not only was celiac, but also vegetarian and allergic to lactose. Barnes did have a family which were able to look after that student, but it meant that the student had to transfer to a different school. The sooner you provide us with this information, the better we're able to support you with your needs. The contact details for your host family, as well as the conventions that you need to sign with the DGEP and Barnes, will be sent to you at a later time. We also recommend that you get into contact with your host families via telephone, Skype, mail, or any other video conferencing tool that you now may be more used to. Normally, my colleague from Barnes Educational Services, Rick Carby, would be in Renon to present this section of the presentation. But as he is not here and we are under lockdown, I am going to have to do my best to introduce Barnes Educational Services to you. So Barnes has been working with homestay solutions for families and students in the UK since 1975. And here you've got a little summary of the next couple of slides. And so without more ado, we'll move on to talk about Barnes' total care package. So Barnes is responsible for the well-being of students in the UK. And your main contact will be Rick Carby, who is the manager for the homestay section of the organisation. His wife is the general manager. Barnes has a permanent link for everybody involved in order to ensure their well-being. And you can contact Barnes on their emergency numbers 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. You can ask any question and they will be only too happy to answer. This also includes future students, of course, so if you have any questions already about your stay in the UK, don't hesitate to give Barnes a call or send them an email so that they can answer your question. You've all completed your inscription formulas, and this has enabled Rick to start the process of finding a suitable host family for you. The next step will be for Barnes to send their legal documents and other information to you via the DGEP, in which they require you to sign a document in which you agree to respect their services. The third and final step will be to introduce you to your host families for the following year. And with this, Barnes will help you to understand each other, to share details. They will meet you, as I mentioned previously, at the airport arrivals lounge, and will help you to make your last preparations before leaving Switzerland, advising you where necessary. And so we come to your arrival in the UK, which we hope will be safe and sound. In the first few days, you're going to learn to cope with a different daily routine, and your host families are there to support you with this process. You might, for example, discover that the bathrooms have carpet, or you might discover that people eat a lot earlier than they do in Switzerland. Or you might indeed discover that breakfasts are a lot more hearty and bigger than in Switzerland. In the first few days, your host family will help you to sign up to a NHS doctor, and they'll also help you to open a bank account if you need one. I know that last year, a number of students asked me about opening up an account before they left for the UK, but many banks won't allow you to open an account unless you have proof of residence in the UK. So I think that it's probably best if you leave this until your arrival. I'd like to reassure you, nevertheless, that as someone who transfers money quite regularly to the UK, it's very easy to do this by bank transfer, and I can do it on my mobile phone. You'll also need to learn to take public transport. This is particularly the case, I think, in London for the students, where the students will need to take a number of buses to get to school. Or, for example, students going to Ulster, where I know most host families are actually located in Stratford. So you'll need to take a bus for about 10 minutes to get to school on time. If you sign up for and get a local transport concession, this will also be useful for your weekends and other time off in the UK, as it will enable you to travel around at reduced prices. You'll also meet the local representative of Barnes. So in each area of the UK, there is one local representative, like a super mom, who is responsible for your well-being. And in times of necessity, the super mom is also the one who might end up looking after you, for example. Your host families will encourage you to take part in local activities. And indeed, a lot of our students have found that it's through these local activities that they've made the most friends. So I can only recommend that you do get involved in organisations such as the Scouts or the National Citizenship Award Scheme, or indeed, and this is a school-based scheme, but the Duke of Edinburgh Award Scheme, which allows students to go on weekend activities with other people their age. Finally, Barnes helps you to cope with homesickness. This is not something to be underestimated. I can remember even at the age of 19, I suffered from this when I travelled to university some 1,000 kilometres away from my hometown. And it's important for you to be honest with not only your own parents, of course, but also your host families and the other students in your cohort about this. It's not something which is at all unusual. In fact, it's something which is very often occurring. And the best thing to do to overcome it is to talk with each other about your fears and worries, and also to find common solutions. A typical day in the UK usually starts with breakfast before you head off to school. Schools usually start a little bit later than in Switzerland, at around 8:45, before finishing also a little bit earlier than in Switzerland, at around 3:45. After school, you may be involved in some extracurricular activities, such as sporting activities or music or theatre-based activities. You might want to get involved in a club, for example, in your local area. Whatever the case, you should maintain contact with your host families and let them know what's going on. Don't expect them to guess that you might be involved in an extra long theatrical rehearsal at your local school. You need to learn to spend time with your host family, because it's also through your host family that you're going to become more integrated with the local community and in the UK in general. While you will be spending a lot of time in your room studying. It's important to pay attention to the amount of noise that you're making if you're listening to music, and also to avoid spending all of your time in your room, as this can be considered antisocial. The point of being placed with a host family is for you to interact with that host family and to create a connection with them. Many of our students go on to maintain this connection after their time abroad and return regularly to meet their host families. We would hope that this is also the case for you. Finally, it's important to spend the correct amount of time in bed. Remember that you have an extremely busy day. Everything is in a foreign language, and it's important to get enough sleep. You should be going to bed at a reasonable time in order to ensure that you're rested and ready for the next day. The host families will act as a loco parentis during your time abroad. This means that they have the authority to act as parents in place of your own parents in Switzerland. This can worry some families in Switzerland, but I'd like to reassure everybody that this really is in an emergency situation. When no other solution is possible, if we cannot, for example, get into contact with the nominated legal representative in Switzerland. Therefore, it's important to have good relations between the parents in Switzerland and the host families in the UK. You should try and be attentive to perhaps the tone that you use when communicating with your host families, and also perhaps the, if not the frequency, then the timing of your contact with the host families in the UK. If you are going to contact somebody angrily at 10 o'clock at night, then you perhaps won't get such a good reception as if you had contacted them calmly at 10 o'clock in the morning. As I mentioned before, some host families will impose a time at which they expect the students to be at home and getting ready for bed. But this is, of course, a negotiation. So if you feel that the time set is too early or too late, then you need to negotiate with the host family in order to reach a compromise. You need to, above all, respect the decisions of your host family. The host families have all been selected by Barnes because of their historical links with the organisation. Many of the families have been with the organisation for a number of years. They've all passed police checks for their suitability to work with young children. And it's important to remember that these host families are there for your help and support over this year abroad. Of course, it's possible to organise time away from the host family. If, for example, you want to spend the night with friends at somebody else's house, and this is quite a common occurrence. But if this is the case, then please let your host families know. Don't just not turn up at night and expect them to guess where you might be. Similarly, if you're planning on going outside the neighbourhood, then it's very important to let your families know where you're going and when you expect to be back. Good communication is the key here. Finally, Barnes organises a day towards the beginning of your time in the UK, usually a Saturday, where you can, or where you're advised to invite a British friend, so somebody from your school, to come with you and the other Swiss students on a day out. The aim of this day is to enforce social links with other students in your school, So not just within the group of Swiss students. And the who you invite or the number of people you invite is a good indication for Barnes regarding your integration in the school. Last year, I remember that one student had so many people on her list that she had to cut down the number of people that she was inviting because it was so many. This, for us, is a great sign that the students are well integrated with the local school and local community. If you're having trouble finding somebody to invite, it's also a sign that perhaps you need more support from Barnes to help you do so. Barnes, as I mentioned before, offers other services and insurance, which means that it's much more than just a place to crash and somewhere to eat. So the insurance that is obligatory is with Ensley. It's a subsidiary of Zurich Insurance Group, and it includes an travel insurance in case of problems with your trip. The insurance offer is an insurance offer for travel, and we should specify that it is not insurance for valuable objects, nor is it a private medical insurance. If you would like to organise these, of course they will be at an additional cost to you. So, to conclude this section for Barnes, they are a company which have been going for a number of years, who have helped many, many students in the UK, and with whom we've worked since 2015 when we started sending students to London and the southeast of England. So together with them, we wish you a great trip to the UK in which you're able to discover much more than just British schools, but also British culture and other local activities that maybe you had not even thought about before going to the UK. Finally, a word on our partner schools. As you can see, I've selected a number of images from our partner schools. So if we start off on the top left, we have Ulster, followed by Bexhill, then Cristleton, Colliers, Stroud, Denmark Road, Exeter, Harrogate, Holcombe and Rochester, Whitchurch, Portsmouth, Radder, Sheldon, St Mary Magdalene's Academy, and finally York. I encourage you to take a look at the social media platforms for each of our partner schools to get an understanding and feel of what makes each school so special. Some are absolutely huge with 7,000 full-time students, 30,000 part-time students. Others are tiny with 600 full-time students and around 100 students in the high school or gymnase section of the school. Some schools are single sex in the middle school, although, again, I remind you that all schools are mixed sex for the high school section of the school. Other schools have dress codes, some schools have uniforms, and other schools still have no codes of dress for the school. Some schools are located in large cities, others are located in more rural situations. Each school has something which makes it special and stand out in a particular way. And I encourage you to get in touch with each of the schools concerned with your particular questions regarding your year abroad. You are soon going to receive an invitation to an online video conference with a representative of our partner schools. And I encourage you to take part in that so that you can get a better understanding of what awaits you during your year abroad. If you have more general questions, then all of the information about the Bilingual Matura is available on the internet, as I mentioned previously, at the following address, www.vd.ch/gymnase. And you can send your questions in English or in French to me at aidan.macdonald@vd.ch. Thank you very much for your time, and I wish you the best of luck in your forthcoming meetings with our partner schools.